you are coming online, wherever you are joining me from this afternoon, this wonderful day, I want you to lift up your hand and let's appreciate our Lord, our God. I want you to lift up your hand and let's adore His holy name. I want you to lift up your hand and give Him thanks, give Him praise for another beautiful time, another wonderful time, another wonderful moment. Today is another Friday by the special grace of God. And every Friday on this platform, we gather together before the Almighty God for a time of communal service. Today, we are here again for another communal service. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. But before we do anything, can we just lift up our hand and let's just appreciate our Lord, our God. From the depth of your heart, I want you to just pick a song and sing unto Him. I want you to pick a song and just sing it unto the King of Kings, to the Lord of Lords, to the Alpha and the Omega. I want you to sing a song unto Him, to just worship Him, to adore His holy name for what He has been doing in your life, for His protection in your life, in your marriage, in your business, in your career. Why not just lift up your hand and wave it unto the King of Kings? Lift up your hand and wave it unto the Lord of Lords. Lift up your hand and celebrate Him this hour. Let's lift up our hand and appreciate our Lord, our God. For our Lord is good, for His mercy endure forever. Lift up your hand and celebrate Him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the gift of life. I want you to just say thank you, Jesus. For your marriage, I want you to say thank you, Jesus. For that protection, for the final encounter, for the hand of God that has been watching over you. The Bible says His eyes watch over you day and night. For the eyes of God that watch over you day and night, I want you to lift up your hand and appreciate Him. Give Him thanks, give Him praise. For our Lord is good. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship You. Lift up your hand and celebrate Him this hour. Lift up your hand and bless His holy name. Lord, we celebrate You. Lord, we celebrate You. Lord, we celebrate You. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Jesus. I want you to lift up your hand and just sing a song unto Him. The Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Lift up your hand and worship Him. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. As you are coming online, lift up your hand and celebrate God. Lift up your hand and worship Him. Sing a song unto Him to appreciate Him. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Wherever you are joining from, lift up your hand and worship Him. Lift up your hand and celebrate Him. Lift up your hand and adore His holy name. Lift up your hand and say, thank you, Jesus, for the gift of life, for sparing your life to this present moment. I want you to lift up your hand and celebrate our Lord, our God. I want you to lift up your hand and still worship Him. It can never, never be enough. Celebrating and appreciating God can never, 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 never be enough. The oxygen you breathe in day and every minute, every second. Some people are paying thousands for it on a daily basis. Why not just lift up your hand and appreciate Him? Lift up your hand and say, Father, thank You for the gift of life. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Jesus. Lift up your hand and adore His holy name. Lift up your hand and say, thank You, Jesus. Worship Him. Worship your Lord, your God this hour. Celebrate Him. Celebrate Him. Celebrate Him. Before we do anything, I just want you to open your mouth and appreciate Him. Open your mouth and give Him thanks. Open your mouth and I celebrate God. Open your mouth and sing a song unto Him to appreciate Him. Lord, we celebrate You. Lord, we celebrate You. Yes, Lord. Say something beautiful, say something wonderful unto Him. Appreciate Him. Appreciate Him. Today is the first Friday in the month, in the sixth month, the month of June. Amen. We enter into this month, to this year together with some people. At the end of January, they are dead. Some people enter February, but they are not able to cross over to March. Many enter into March, but they are not able to enter into June, to April. You enter into April, you enter into May, you enter, and this is June. Lift up your hand and appreciate Him. Lift up your hand and worship Him. Celebrate Him. Give Him thanks, give Him praise. For our Lord is good. For His mercy endure forever. For our Lord is good. For His mercy endure forever. For our Lord is good. For His mercy endure forever. I want you to celebrate Him. I want you to adore His holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship you. Thank you, mighty Father. Lord, we say thank you. We give you praise, we give you honor. We give you praise, we give you honor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have worship. Let us pray. Our Lord, our God, I want to say thank you for this hour. We bless your holy name in the name of Jesus. We give you praise, we give you honor. For the gift of life, our marriage, for our husband, our wife, our children, for our loved one, for our family member, we return all glory, all honor back to you this hour in the name of Jesus. Father, as we gather again today, Lord, let heaven open upon us in the name of Jesus. Heavens of mercy, heavens of favor, heavens of healing, heavens of divine encounter, let it open upon each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. Sweet Holy Spirit, arise in your power. Today, glorify your holy name in our midst in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we are praying. In Jesus' name we are praying. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I welcome each and every one of us to today's communal service in the name of Jesus. For those that are joining us for the very first time, my name is Ariola Oreoluwa, and this is Praying Eagles Network. Praying Eagles Network, coming live and direct from Lagos State, Nigeria. Wherever you are joining us from, or you are listening to this audio podcast, you are all welcome in the name of Jesus. For those of you who are joining us live and direct on Facebook, and for those of you on Instagram, amen, I celebrate you. I celebrate the grace of God upon your life. I celebrate God. I appreciate God for your life. I bless the name of our Lord our God for sparing your life to this present moment. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. As I said, this is Praying Eagles Network, and my name is Ariola Oreoluwa. I am the prayer coordinator of this online prayer ministry. By the grace of God, every Friday, according to the mandate of God for this ministry, we come online 12 noon Nigeria time to have communal service. Communal service every Friday, 12 noon Nigeria time. And the same every Friday, 11:30 p.m. in the night, we have our weekly Fiji. Amen. Every Friday, two programs, the communal service, 12 noon Nigeria time, as we are about to have it right now. And in the evening, what do we have? In the evening, we have, by the special grace of God in the night, we have the weekly Fiji. And the last day of every month, we always have our monthly Fiji. Praise the Lord. And every Saturday, we have Restoring Family Prayer Altar, where the whole family will gather together to intercede for their family. Tomorrow is another day, 8 p.m. Nigeria time, on this same platform. We are going to gather together, and I will be teaching us how to pray for our family, how to secure our home, how to secure our marriage all over the world. There are many evil, there are many atrocities, there are many things that are going on right now. So we need to secure our home. We need to secure our home in the place of prayer. We need to secure our home in the place of prayer. Amen. You need to secure your marriage if you are a woman. Amen. You need to secure the destiny of your husband and your children. The same thing happened to the fathers in the house. Amen. So join me tomorrow, Saturday, 8 p.m. on this platform as we come to intercede for our family. The Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. And also, every Sunday, we always have our online Sunday service, 12 noon Nigeria time, on this same platform. The Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. Once again, wherever you are joining me from, those of you on Facebook, I can see you. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. I can see those of you on Instagram. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. And for those of you who will be listening to this podcast, may the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Every Friday, we come online for communal service. And every first Friday, If you notice, every first Friday, I always take time to pray. Amen. We use it to pray using the blood of Jesus. So today is the first Friday in this 6 months. What we'll be doing today is all the teaching, all what we have learned for the past few weeks, we'll be applying them strictly in the place of prayer today. Today is practical. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Amen. So today, we'll be praying with the blood of Jesus. As you can see on the title, praying with the blood of Jesus Christ. We'll be praying for ourselves, for our family, everything about us using the blood of Jesus. Amen. But before we do that, I would like to share the 6 basic principles that guided Holy Communion. The 6 basic principles that guided Holy Communion. Amen. Before we begin to take communion and we pray. Amen. The first principle that guided the Holy Communion is you must be born again. You must be born again. Romans 10, verse 9 and verse 10, and John 12, 42. Amen. Romans. Amen. You must be born again. Romans 10, verse 9 and verse 10, and John 12, 42. Said that you must be born again. Not only that you believe in your heart, but you must confess Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Number two, communion can be taken any day. On Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, any day of the week, you can take communion. The third one, you can take communion any time of the day. Any time of the day, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, in the night. Amen. There is no law that states that it must be taken on a particular time of the day. Communion can be taken any time of the day. The fourth one, the communion is not only to be taken in the church. The Bible shows us in Acts 2:46, Matthew 26:18-30, that Jesus Christ himself did not take his own communion inside the church, inside the tabernacle. He took it in a house, in one of the houses of his disciples. Amen. So if Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, took his own holy communion inside the house of one of his disciples, hear me, sir, hear me, man. You too, you can take communion anywhere you find yourself. Inside the car, in your office, in your house, among your brethren, you are out there on a picnic, you can take communion. Praise the Lord. The next one. Who can administer communion? By the grace of God. Number one, the first law, you must be born again before you receive the communion. But for me to give you, to administer communion to you, what right, spiritual right, do I have to administer communion? Amen. Revelation 1:6 says, and hath made us kings and priests. Jesus has made us king and priest. King and priest. Amen. So it's only those who are priests. I didn't say, did I say pastor? I don't remember that I said pastor. So you don't quote me that it said only pastor. I didn't mention pastor. I said priest. Say it after me. Say priest. I can't hear you. Say, I want you to repeat. Say priest. So the Bible says that Jesus Christ had made us kings and priests. So it's only those who are priests unto the living God that can administer communion. So the day you gave your life to Christ and you receive the calling, the day you gave your life to Christ, you submit yourself under the authority of Jesus Christ, amen, you have right that day. Because the moment you give your life to Christ, the moment you submit everything to Christ, you become a king and you become a priest unto the living God. So you have right. So the spiritual legal right I have to administer communion to you today is from that revelation. Jesus Christ has made me priest unto him. So I stand upon that to administer communion to you. And the first law, because you believe, you have confessed with your mouth, you have legal right, amen, you have spiritual right to receive the communion. Praise the Lord. And last but not the least, what are the material for you to take, to use, to administer communion? What are the material? What are those material? Amen. That you and I can use. Amen. Matthew 26:26-28. And the Bible says, as they were eating, he took the bread. As they were eating, Jesus took the bread, blessed it, break it, and gave it to the disciple, and said, take, eat, this is my body. Verse 27. And he took the cup, and gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it. 28. For this is my blood of the New Testament. Amen. So the Bible says, as they were eating, he took the what? He took the bread. He break it, he blesses. Amen. Before we pray today, I received like three or four questions during the week. After last week communion, some people are asking, and the question came from, I think, four questions, and from different people, and was talking, the summary of that question was that they were asking, how do we prepare communion? Amen. They were asking, how do we prepare communion? I answered the first person when I received, I said, there's no spiritual thing, there's no spiritual, they said, and the person replied back that, oh, in my church, there's a process, there's a principle. I just laughed. There is no spiritual principle. Amen. That is why today, I didn't prepare my own communion. I'm going to do it in your presence, because, you know, we are learning day by day. Amen. And when the second question came in, I was, what is going on? And the four of them are from different nations. So, which means some of us think that, oh, maybe there are some things that go underground. There's nothing that is underground. Amen. There's nothing that is underground. So, because of that, I did not prepare my own communion today. I'm going to bring out a bottle of water. Amen. You know, I always share with us that the communion for the material for us to use to prepare communion. If you have bread, bring out your bread. If you have biscuit, bring out your biscuit. If you have wafer, bring out your wafer. If it is cake, bring it out. The ultimate is you have something as a token to represent it. Amen. And you bless it. Amen. Praise the Lord. The moment you bless it, what happened? The moment you bless it, amen, it becomes the communion. Amen. And you begin to make use of it. Praise the Lord. The moment you bless it, it becomes material and you begin to make use of it. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. So, by the grace of God, I'm waiting for those who are on Facebook to join us back. Amen. Once I have them, I want to bring my material out so that I prepare it in their presence, for because of those who are saying, Pastor, how do we prepare communion service? They want to learn. They want to know. Some of them say, oh, maybe there is something special. There is a special thing on how to prepare. Hear me, sir. Hear me, man. There is nothing special. There is nothing new. There is nothing strange in preparing communion. There is nothing special. There is nothing new in preparing communion. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. I believe we have our brethren back now. Amen. Once we have them back, I believe I'll be free to go so that they too can join us. Amen. I want them to join us so that we all learn together how to administer the communion. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sorry, I'm waiting for the Facebook people so that it won't be that we are the only one that is. Amen. So that they won't complain that they don't see it. Amen. Okay. I think they are around the corner. Facebook people, where are you? Amen. Sorry, I'm waiting for Facebook people. Where are they? Let them come online so that the Facebook lock them out so that we can continue. Praise the Lord. Let's just give them 1 minute. Amen. Especially those who are saying, how do we prepare communion? How do we prepare communion? They want to know how to prepare communion. Amen. Somebody is asking volume. How do we prepare communion? Amen.
Give him thanks, give him praise. For our Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Are we ready now? I'm trying to wait for the Facebook people to join us. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we celebrate you at this hour. We give you praise. We give you honor. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I believe they are back now. The Facebook people are back live online. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. So, let's give them 1 minute so that they can join us. Let them join us. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. For those of us who are online right now, we appreciate our Lord, our God. We bless His holy name for another wonderful opportunity to gather again today for another time of communion. May the name of our Lord, our God, be glorified in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Facebook locked us out, but we are back. Amen. Praise the Lord. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. I celebrate each and every one of you. Those of us on Facebook, those of us on Instagram, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. I believe we are back now. Amen. So, we go back to where the Facebook logos out. Some people are asking, how do we prepare communion? Somebody said, when I said, there is no spiritual thing, nothing strange about it. And he replied back that, in our church, it's like, there's nothing like, amen. Number one, you must be born again. Number two, as long as you are born again, you became a priest. So you can prepare communion in your house. That is the reason I refuse to prepare my own communion. Because when I said that, and the next question, the third person asked us, Pastor, was that all? I said, that was all. There's nothing again to add it. So today, I'm going to bring in my own material afresh. I will prepare it. Amen. You know, I said today, what we are going to do is we are going to pray. Amen. But the one of the assignments of this ministry is to shed light on some of the areas in which we don't really understand. Amen. I'm going to bring in my own material. I will prepare my own communion in your presence, and we go into the time of prayer. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. So that's nothing new. Because I'm in the office, if I'm in the house, I always make use of bread. Amen. Because we always have bread to eat at home. So because I'm not in the house, I'm in the office. So I have this, that which I kept in the office. And what we have inside is this, I will show us. Is this. Just a flat, they call it a communion meal. Amen. This is what we are using. I'm going to use, amen. I think you can see it now. Praise the Lord. And you can make use, if you have a bottle of water, because you are in the office, you are inside your office. Amen. That's you may not have access to wine or access to fruit juice, but you have access to bottled water. So please bring out that bottled water. We pray on it, you use it. I keep repeating it. And if what you have access to is a cup of water, please bring out the cup of water. We pray on it. Amen. We bless it and we use it. Amen. And if you have wine, amen. There are some of us who have access to some of this material which people sell for communion. They sell it in some churches. Amen. If you have access to it, please bring it out. You will make use of it. And if not, amen. If you have a salt drink, you have fruit juice, please bring it out. Pour some. You don't need much. Just pour some inside your cup. Amen. And you put it before you. And if you don't, that's why I'm not showing the brand name of this, so that some of us, we don't turn it to another thing. We are looking for the brand name. Amen. So just put some in your cup. If what you have is glass cup, please make use of that glass cup. Amen. Praise the Lord. And as I said, if you don't have access to that, to any of these things, but you have access to bottled water, please bring out the bottled water. We pray on it, we make use of it. Amen. Right now, I have my flesh here, I have my wine here, and I have my bottled water here. I'm free to go. Praise the Lord. I'm free to go. You want to prepare it in your house? It's as simple as this. Once you prepare it, but at least if you want to give gifts unto God, unto your governor, unto your husband. There's a way you prepare it. You don't just prepare it anywhere. You put it on a special place. You package it. Amen. Amen. You like the word packing. Amen. The same thing. So when you are preparing communion, don't just take any cup anyhow. Any cup, dirty plate. No! We are talking about the blood of Jesus Christ and the flesh of our Lord Jesus Christ. You prepare it. You reference it. You reference it. You honor it. That is all it takes. It's your heart. It's your heart that matter. You reference it. Once you reference it, once you honor it. Amen. By the grace of God, I have glass cup here. Because that glass cup is what I used to drink water in this office. That's why I brought this. The communion cup. So that each time I want to take communion, when some people come to the office and I pray for them, maybe on healing, and I want to serve communion, I don't just use the cup I will use to drink water. Because it is communion, the flesh and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. I must honor it. I must not know it. I must reference it. Praise the Lord. That is why I come up with this. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. That is all. So once you have prepared them, if you want to prepare it in your house, amen, assume that it's not online. You want to prepare in your house, you want to serve your children, serve your husband, serve yourself, or in your office. Once you prepare it like this, the next thing is, you just lift up your hand. You bless the name of our Lord, our God. You appreciate Him for giving you our Lord Jesus Christ. It's not easy. It's not easy. Please, my brother, it's not an easy task. The Bible said Jesus Christ is only begotten Son, and He released His only begotten Son to go and die for you and for me. So you need to respect Him, you need to appreciate Him, you need to thank Him, you need to appreciate Him. So you lift up your hand, you appreciate God. When you appreciate God, you bless Him for giving you Jesus Christ, and you appreciate, you thank Jesus Christ for submitting Himself. If God said Jesus Christ go, and Jesus Christ said I'm not going. If God said, go and die for the sin of the world, and He said, I'm not going to die for the sin of the world, my sister, my brother, there's nothing you and I will do. In the Garden of Gethsemane, He saw the death, He saw the pain, He saw the agony. The Bible said He was lamenting, He was wailing. It's like it will change. But suddenly He said, oh, Lord, not of my will, but let your will. He saw the death, so it's not an insister. So you appreciate God, and after appreciating God, you appreciate Jesus Christ Himself for releasing his life. Amen. And after that, what do? You lift up the cup. What do you want to use the communion for? Communion for fruitfulness, as we have it in the last 3 days. Or you want to use it for healing. Or you want to use it for protection. Amen. You address it. Address the communion. Address the communion. If it's for healing, you have the breath of the Almighty God for healing to come upon it. As I take this communion, I take it for healing in the name of Jesus. As I take it, let the new breath, the breath of Jesus Christ in this blood, the life of Jesus Christ in this blood, let it flow into my system. That is all. You want to use it for example, for those who are believing God for fruit of the womb, yesterday, the last 3 days, you see that I quoted the scripture. You quote one or two scriptures you know and which minister to that thing. You quote it, you recite it on it. And the moment you recite it on it, amen, you use it. It's by faith. It's by faith. And when you use it, amen, you take one or two prayer and you go and you begin to enjoy it. Amen. That is all. Sir, ma, there's no any other thing after this. Amen. You see, I have to come online and prepare my own in your presence. Amen. To answer those questions, and for some of us who are saying, Pastor, we want to prepare communion in our house, but we don't know how to go about it. It's as simple as this. No more, no less. If you have bread in your house, cut the bread into a smaller size. Don't just take a loaf of bread. Amen. Just you want to take a, amen. You are not eating food. Amen. You are not taking me. Amen. It's as simple as that. Amen. May the Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. By the grace of God, this is just the simple way to prepare communion. And another thing, let me add this to you. If you are preparing it for a family, maybe you, one or two or three people, amen. You know, as I said, you need to reference and honor it. It's a holy thing. As you are preparing communion, you don't prepare communion and you are gisting. Hey, my friend, you don't see that woman, hey, that latest clothes. No, that is worldly thing. You don't begin to share worldly things on communion. That is why in those days, in the book of Acts, each time they want to take communion, you see them crying, you see them weeping. You see them as if, it's as if they are mourning. Yes, they are mourning our Lord Jesus Christ. Because they reference it. This blood, the moment you prepare it, if it is water before. But the moment you say it is communion, it's not only communion. It has become the blood of Jesus. And they begin to imagine, oh, this is the blood of a man that I want to take. And they kill that man for my sake. You don't prepare it and you are talking and you are gisting. No. When you are preparing it for yourself, for people around you, if possible, just mature. As my people say, keep quiet, don't talk. Just begin to meditate. Begin to think about the life and death of our Lord Jesus Christ. Begin to think of what you want to use it for and how Jesus Christ is going to do perform wonder. Begin to speak in tongues. If you can speak in tongues, begin to speak in tongues inside. Amen. These are things we need to do. And we made the communion. Some people are saying, oh, I'll be taking communion, but it's not working. Yes, how do you prepare it? That is the first thing I ask. And apart from preparation, when you are preparing, what are the things you are doing? You are preparing communion. You are chewing bubbles gum in your mouth. You are preparing the communion, the flesh of our Lord Jesus Christ, bro. And you are chewing chewing gum in your mouth. Yum, 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 yum. You are preparing communion. You have bitterness against other people in your heart. It will not work. It will not work. It will not work. So you need to, that's why the Bible says we should check inwardly. Check yourself that you are living holy. And after that, you prepare it. And what is the next thing? You pray on it. I've explained how you pray on it. And that is it. You take it. And as you take it, there will be testimony in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. That is how to do it. So today we are doing practical. Am I right? Today is a practical class. So I'm going to pray on it. Amen. So as I'm praying on my own, you too, you pray on your own. We take it. After we take it, we come back. And I will tell us 10 significant of the blood of Jesus. 10 important of the blood of Jesus. Oh, I should share that before we take it. Because I want you to take it. As you take it, we begin to apply it. We begin to take prayer. We begin to use the blood to address some things in our life this month. Amen. Praise the Lord. What are the 10 most important benefits of the blood of Jesus according to the scripture? Number one, Ephesians 1:7 made us to know that we are saved by the blood of Jesus. You and I are saved from the wrath of sin, from the wrath of death, from God's wrath. You are saved by the blood of Jesus. Ephesians 1:7. Hebrews 9:22 made us to know that we are washed clean by the blood of Jesus. We are washed and made whole, made clean. From what? From sin, from pollution, from contamination. Through what? By the blood of Jesus. It's only the blood of Jesus Christ that can cleanse you. It's only the blood of Jesus Christ that can make you whole. Number three, Colossians 1:20. The Bible said, for example, in the Garden of Eden, when separation came between Adam and God, there was no peace again. But according to Colossians 1:20, it tells us that by the blood of Jesus, we have peace with our God. You have peace with your God. As a couple, if there's no peace between the two of you, you cannot come and meet your partner and ask for anything. He won't answer you. Am I right? Am I right? You are not even free to come and ask and even talk to him. But when there's peace between the two of you, you just come and darling, sweetheart, honey pie, sugar pie, amen. What name do you call your husband? Amen. You ask. As you are asking, you are taking it. See that? As you are asking, because the thing are available, you are taking the thing. But if there's no peace between you and your partner, you cannot come and take. To even ask will be difficult. But the moment there is peace, for example, this is what I want. My wife will come. I won't tell you how my wife used to call me. And as she's asking, she is taking it. If I want to look at her, she just touch my cheek like this. And what will I do? I just smile. Don't mind me. Old man, may God help us. My sister, the same thing with God. By the time the blood of Jesus Christ bring peace, make peace between us and God, as you are coming, as you are asking God, you are receiving. As you are asking, you are receiving. As you are asking, you are receiving. But if there is no peace, you are asking, it's bouncing back. Amen. The next one, Hebrews 9:22. May tell us that by the blood of Jesus, we have been forgiven. Iniquity may separate us from God. Iniquity did not allow God to give us what we want. But because of the blood of Jesus, we have been forgiven. So there's nothing to use against us. The accuser of the brethren, there's nothing the accuser of the brethren is going to use against you to hinder your prayer. You have been forgiven by the blood of Jesus. Leviticus 17:11. The book of Leviticus 17:11. We are healed by the blood of Jesus. For those of us who are wasting our money, our time on one ailment or the other, the Bible says we are healed by the blood of Jesus. So what you just need to do is take the blood of Jesus, administer it to yourself, proclaim it, activate it. I've been healed by the blood of Jesus. Why is sickness living in my body? Today, by the blood of Jesus, any seed of sickness, of infirmity in my body, die in the name of Jesus. That is the end. I receive a new life by the blood of Jesus. The life of Christ, the life of Zoe, everlasting life, I receive it by the blood of Jesus. That is it. Romans 5:9 tell us that we have been justified by the blood of Jesus. For me to come online and break communion, listen to me, I'm justified for this assignment by the blood of Jesus. The devil cannot hold anything against this program. Oh, he's running an online ministry. Why must he be running an online ministry? Oh, yeah. Amen. I'm justified to run this online ministry by the blood of Jesus. My sister, that your marriage, you are justified to be fulfilling that home by the blood of Jesus. That your business, you are justified for that business to prosper by the blood of Jesus. Amen. The contract that you bid for, you are justified to receive it by the blood of Jesus. So why is devil still attacking you? Why is devil still attacking say no to it? Lift up the blood of Jesus and administer that by the blood of Jesus, I'm justified. Amen. Let me give us two more because of our time. The next one, John 6:55-59. We have eternal life by the blood of Jesus. We have eternal life by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, you have eternal life. So, devil, COVID-19, or his brother or his sister cannot tamper with you, cannot take your life. You remember the what did they call it? The cat with nine lives. Your own is not with nine lives. Because the cat with nine lives, if you kill the cat today, it remains eight. You kill it tomorrow, it remains seven. Gradually, it will remain one. And the last one, that will be the end. But you have eternal life through the blood of Jesus. So devil, sickness, infirmity, amen, cannot take your life. Cannot take your life. Cannot take your life. You have eternal life through the blood of Jesus. How do you receive the eternal life? When you take the blood of Jesus, the life of Jesus Christ is in that blood. So, for example, if death is killing people around you, at the beginning of the month, what you just need to do, that's why I'm bringing the practical today. Every beginning of every month, take the blood of Jesus as insurance. You take it, as I take this blood of Jesus Christ today, in the name of Jesus, throughout this month, I insure my life. I will not die. My family will not die. In the name of Jesus, I reject accident. If you are passing through the road, and the road is swallowing people, listen to me, you will pass, nothing will happen to you. Instead of that, God will lock you behind, will not allow you to pass at that time. Why? Because you have eternal life, you cannot die. Have you heard about accident and the people will die inside the bus? 10, almost about 18, 15 people. It's only one person that will survive. Some will survive without a single scratch on their body. And you'll be wondering, only you, other people died. How come? Because they have eternal life. Go and check. Go and watch. They are children of the living God. They have eternal life through the blood of Jesus Christ in them. How do you have about plane crash? And people will die inside, they will die. But one way or the other, somebody will survive. How do you have a plane crash? That the name of a particular person will be inside the manifesto of that plane. And at the end of the day, you hear a story. And something hold me back. I was not able to meet up with the plane. Some people, their load will be inside the plane. And one way or the other, they will escape. Why? Because they have eternal life. Hear me, sir. Hear me, ma'am. Today, as you are going to take the blood of Jesus Christ, you are going to receive eternal life in the name of Jesus. For you, for your family member, you are receiving eternal life in the name of Jesus. COVID-19, any ravenous bed, any ravenous sickness, anything that is killing people around, in that name, they will spare your life and your loved one in the name of Jesus. I love this one. Exodus 12:13. By the blood of Jesus, our life, our marriage, everything about us are under protection. I love this. That is what God always gives me assurance. Each time I need to go out in the morning, come back in the evening, sometimes I need to go out for days. Amen. It's not that I don't think about my wife or my children, but there's this assurance that by the blood of Jesus, my family are protected. Everything about me are under the cover of the blood of Jesus. Before you can touch them, before you can hate them, before you can hate me, you must touch the blood of Jesus. And touch the blood of Jesus, you are touching the life of Jesus. Is it possible? It's not possible. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, taking the blood of Jesus, these are some of the benefits that will be enjoyed. Amen. Can we lift up our communion as I pray on it? And we take it and we take one or two prayers for today. Lift it up. Father, I want to say thank you for today. We appreciate you for today's communion. We say thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for our marriage. Thank you for our business. Thank you for our career. Thank you for your protection upon us. Thank you for justifying us with the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ that protect us. Thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ that sanctify us. Thank you for the eternal life through the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the healing we are receiving through the blood of Jesus. Thank you for forgiving us through the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the peace that we receive through the blood of Jesus. Thank you for cleansing us with the blood of Jesus. Thank you for saving us with the blood of Jesus. Thank you for delivering us from the hand of devil with the blood of Jesus. We turn all glory back to you in the name of Jesus. As we take this communion today, we take it for life. We take it for protection. We take it for signs and wonder. We take it for healing. We take it for lifting. In the name of Jesus, breathe upon it, O Lord, the breath of life. In the name of Jesus, thank you, mighty Father. Jesus' name we are praying. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. So now you take the flesh first, and you take the blood. As you are taking the blood, begin to administer it. As the blood is entering into your body, begin to administer it. If there is sickness, if there are ailments in your body, begin to mention that area and begin to receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Concern your husband, concern your wife, concern your children, begin to decree and declare it. Amen. As you are taking the blood, begin to silently pray. Commune with the blood. Speak to the blood. Amen. Thank you, Father. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you honor. Blessed be your holy name. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we appreciate you. Lift up your hand and appreciate his holy name. Bless his holy name. Give him thanks, give him praise. Now begin to plead that blood of Jesus upon your spirit, soul, and body, upon your life, your marriage, your business, your career, the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus upon your spirit, soul, and body. The blood, 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 the blood of Jesus, 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 the blood of Jesus. Jesus' name we have decreed. Listen to Exodus 23:26. That shall not he cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The numbers of their days I will fulfill. Two things there. Number one, you will not lose anyone. You will not lose your loved one. You will not lose your younger one. You will not lose your husband. You will not lose your wife. You will not lose your children in the name of Jesus. And he said, no one will be barren. No one will be barren. Barrenness is not in the diary of the Almighty God. Do you hear me, man? Barrenness is not in the diary of the Almighty God. And number three, he said, the numbers of their days I will fulfill. That means you will not die suddenly. You will not die suddenly. So you are going to administer the blood of Jesus Christ to those 30. Say in the name of Jesus throughout this month concerning me and my family member. We will not die suddenly. In the name of Jesus, we reject death. In the name of Jesus, we reject death. In the name of Jesus, we reject death. We will not die suddenly. In the name of Jesus, concerning myself, my wife, my children, concerning your husband, concerning your wife, in the name of Jesus, we reject spirit of death, we reject accident, we reject fire accident, we reject road accident, we reject the spirit of mortuary in the name of Jesus. No one, no none of us will not lose anybody in the name of Jesus. The protection for our Lord Jesus Christ is upon us. We receive the protection by the blood of Jesus. Say by the blood of Jesus, we are under his protection. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say in the name of Jesus, say by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we reject barrenness. In the name of Jesus, say concerning the fruit of the womb, concerning our marriage, concerning our business, concerning our career, we shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I can't hear you, my sister. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. Begin to declare and declare. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Decree and declare. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall be fruitful. Decree and declare. You will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Say I will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. This month, by the blood of Jesus, I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Decree and declare. Say I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Throughout this month, I shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. What about you, man? What about you, sir? Decree and declare. Say I shall be fruitful this very month in the name of Jesus. Concerning the work of my hand, by the blood of Jesus, I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, I shall be fruitful. I shall be fruitful. Why not begin to decree and declare? Decree, prophesy by the blood of Jesus. Say I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, this very month, I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, this very month, I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, this very month, I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, I shall be fruitful. Decree and declare, you will be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, you will be fruitful. You will be fruitful. You will be fruitful. Maritally, you will be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, you will be fruitful. Decree and declare, say I shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, I will be fruitful. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Say in the name of Jesus. I can't hear you, my sister. I want you to say it louder. You know, we are talking with boldness. Are you hearing me? When you are praying with the blood of Jesus, you are praying with what? With boldness. Say in the name of Jesus. Say by the blood of Jesus, I speak peace. Listen, if the Bible says you obtain peace with God by the blood of Jesus, what about with your husband? What about with your wife? What about with your relative? What about with your boss? Say in the name of Jesus. Say by the blood of Jesus, I receive peace. In the name of Jesus, all around me, say I decree peace. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, I decree peace. In the name of Jesus, begin to decree peace upon your life, your marriage, your business, your career. In the name of Jesus, say by the blood of Jesus, I decree peace. In the name of Jesus, in every area of my life, I receive peace. In the name of Jesus, between you and your husband, between you and your wife, between you and your children, begin to decree peace. In the name of Jesus, say I decree peace. In the name of Jesus, the peace of Almighty God, I receive peace. In the name of Jesus, I receive peace. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Romans 8:1-2. Romans 8:1-2. There is therefore now no condemnation to me who is in Christ. By the blood of Jesus, say in the name of Jesus, no more condemnation. In the name of Jesus, my marriage, my business, my career, I shall not be condemned. In the name of Jesus, my marriage will not be condemned. My business will not be condemned. My proposal will not be condemned. In the name of Jesus, no more condemnation concerning me. In the name of Jesus, my sister decree, say in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, because I am in Christ, no more condemnation. In the name of Jesus, the work of my hand will not be condemned. My business will not be condemned. In the name of Jesus, no more condemnation. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Say in the name of Jesus, throughout this month and beyond. You know, today is first Friday of the month, so we still have a long way to go this month. So declare the God. Say in the name of Jesus, say throughout this month, by the blood of Jesus, I reject accident. I reject air accident road accident, sea accident, domestic accident, fire accident. Begin to measure them. Say I reject any form of accident in and around me. In the name of Jesus, concern my going out and my coming back. Concern your husband, concern your wife, concern your children, concern your neighbor, concern your relative. Say I reject accident. In the name of Jesus, we reject accident. In the name of Jesus, we reject accident. In the name of Jesus, we reject accident. Jesus' name we are taking. The Bible said, no weapon form or fashion against you. It didn't say it will not, they will not form it. But the Bible said, no weapon form or fashion against you will prosper. It simply means they will form it, but it will not prosper. So begin to declare and declare. Say any weapon of warfare, any satanic weapon, any weapon of darkness, fashion against me, my marriage, my business, my career, in the name of Jesus, you will not prosper. You will not prosper. You will not prosper. You will not prosper. Because the Bible said they will not prosper. Begin to declare and declare that by the blood of Jesus, any weapon of hell, any weapon of darkness, any weapon of darkness, any satanic weapon against me, my marriage, my business, my health, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, weapon of death, weapon of stagnation, weapon of delay, weapon of punishment that have been formed, that have been fashioned against you, your mom, your marriage, your health, your finance. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. 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 Decree and declare, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, they will not prosper. In Jesus' name, we are beginning. Say in the name of Jesus, I take divine insurance. I can't hear you. Say, I take divine insurance by the blood of Jesus against spiritual and physical accident, against physical and spiritual attack in the name of Jesus. Say, by the blood of Jesus, I take divine insurance in the name of Jesus against attack on my life, on my health, on my marriage, on my business, on my career. By the blood of Jesus, I take divine insurance in the name of Jesus. I take divine immunity by divine insurance against attack in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say this month, I can't hear you, my sister. Say this month and beyond, any evil hand stretched to my life, any hand of death, hand of sickness, any satanic hand stretched to my life, stretched to my marriage, stretched to my business, stretched to my career, begin to declare and declare, let the hand be paralyzed, let the hand wither in the name of Jesus. Any evil hand that the enemy is pointing towards you, pointing towards your children, your husband, your home, your business, your career, decree and declare, let the hand wither in the name of Jesus. Let it wither, 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 let it wither. Satanic hand, hand of death, hand of accident, hand of evil, straight towards you in the name of Jesus. Decree and declare, let it wither, 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 let it wither in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say in the name of Jesus. Say, I put my destiny, my marriage, my children, my spouse, my career, my head, my body, my brain, my environment, my home, everything about me. Say in the name of Jesus. Say, I put them inside the pool of the blood of Jesus for deliverance, for cleansing, for healing, for protection, for lifting. In the name of Jesus. Now begin to dip yourself, your children, your husband, everything about you, your destiny, your career, the work of your hand, your marriage, your finance, your children, your career, your possession. What about your health? This month, you will not suffer crisis. In the name of Jesus, begin to dip everything. What about your environment, your home, your house, your marriage? Begin to dip them inside the blood of Jesus. That 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 blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. The last prayer that we are going to pray this hour, and by the grace of God, let's not forget, today is another Friday. We always meet for our weekly feature. If you are not be joining us, oh, you are not missing Jesus' name. But hear me, people are giving testimony. People are testifying. You too, why not come along? Amen. Join us tonight. Amen. 11:30 p.m. on conference call lab. It's just for 1 hour. 1 hour hot prayer. Amen. Avalanche of prayer. Amen. Just for 1 hour. 11:30 to 12:30. Amen. If you better come on time so that you find seat. Amen. So that by the time you come, you that won't be seat again. Amen. I especially invite each and every one of us. Please come online tonight for our weekly Fiji. Amen. Zechariah 9, verse 11. Zechariah 9, verse 11. Please, man, write it down. If you have your Bible with you, after this, I want you to go and read it. Meditate on it. Because I'm going to give you assignment. Zechariah 9, verse 11. As for me, Oreluwa Ariola, as for this ministry, Pray Nichols Network, Pray Nichols Academy, as for my wife, as for my children, as for each and every one of you, by the blood of covenant, the Lord has sent us forth as a prisoner out of the pit where there is no water. A pit where there is no water, talk about a life without what? Without resources, without help. Eh? A pit without water, a life without destiny helpers. You lack basic amenities. You lack the resources that will lift you up. Amen. But the Bible is saying, by the blood of covenant. What is that blood of covenant? The blood of Jesus. God is saying, He's lifting you up. Amen. Are you happy? So you are going to declare. Say, by the blood of Jesus, I'm coming out. Out of where? Begin to mention it. Out of season of delay, in the name of Jesus. Season of setback, season of limitation, in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, I'm coming out. In the name of Jesus, I'm coming out. In the name of Jesus, I'm coming out. In the name of Jesus. Begin to declare and declare. Say, I'm coming out. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus. I'm coming out from a season of lack in the name of Jesus. From position of lack, I'm coming out in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, I'm coming out in the name of Jesus. To level of promotion in the name of Jesus. From the place of insufficiency, I'm coming out in the name of Jesus. From the position of barrenness, I'm coming out in the name of Jesus. 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 I'm coming out. In Jesus' name, we are coming out. As I have decreed and declared today, by the blood of Jesus, you are coming out in the name of Jesus. I said you have come out in the name of Jesus. As you are coming out, move forward in the name of Jesus. Move forward in the name of Jesus. Move upward in the name of Jesus. Move forward in the name of Jesus. Move upward in the name of Jesus. So shall he be. Jesus' name, we have decreed. I pray for each and every one of you that by the blood of Jesus, the Lord will secure you. Secure your home, your life, your marriage throughout this month and beyond in Jesus' name. Amen. For those of you who partner with me on this assignment, this month, the Lord will watch over you. The Lord will keep you in the name of Jesus. Devourer will not find way in your life, in your marriage, in your business, your career, in the name of Jesus. Amen. And for those of us who want to join me, you are saying, Pastor, I want to partner with you, or I want to send in my seat, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Amen. We're just sending a message to the phone number +234 80 62 68 62 55. Just send account detail. I'll send you that account detail. As you partner with me, as you send in your seed, your tithe to move this ministry forward and upward, your life, your marriage, your business, your career will move forward and upward in the name of Jesus. As you send in your seed, your tithe, as you partner with me in the name of Jesus to move this work of God forward in the name of Jesus, perfection comes your way in the name of Jesus. I said perfection comes your way in the name of Jesus. Till we meet again next week Friday for another communal service, or tonight for our weekly Fiji, or tomorrow Saturday 8 p.m. on this same platform. Amen. For restoring family prayer altar, where we teach ourselves how to pray, how to secure our home, secure our marriage, secure our children, our husband, our wife in the place of prayer. Tomorrow, 8 p.m. or on Sunday, 12 noon Nigeria time for our online Sunday service. Go forth under the cover of our Lord Jesus Christ. And don't forget, Sama, I love each and every one of you with the love of Christ. God bless you. Jesus' name.